Hello, check. All right, people, I believe we are live. Welcome to Catalysis by Vedantu. If I'm audible and visible, please write you in the chat box. You know the drill. Yes. So, people, today we are here to do something very, very important from the chapter of gaseous state, and that is the van der Waals equation. Till date, we have done kinetic theory of gases. We have learnt about the basic ideas of ideal gas. We have also seen in the kinetic theory of gases how we relate the microscopic to macroscopic quantities. Also, we have covered the Dalton's law of partial pressures. We have also covered the Graham's law of diffusion. Yes, तो आज अपन करेंगे वैन डर वॉल्स इक्वेशन. नाउ, एज यू ऑलरेडी नो दैट इन रियालिटी आइडियल गैस डज नॉट एग्जिस्ट, सो वी नीड एन इक्वेशन फॉर रियल गैसेज. सो ऑफकोर्स वी आर नॉट सो स्मार्ट दैट वी कैन यू नो सडनली जस्ट गो टू रियल गैस इक्वेशन. देर इज नो स्पेसिफिक थिंग एज अ रियल गैस इक्वेशन. ओके, नो परफेक्ट रियल गैस इक्वेशन एग्जिस्ट. Whatever exists are just corrections of the ideal gas law. Okay, so you make an ideal law and then you say, okay, now let's do this, this will be better. Okay, now let's do this, this will be better. So once again, remember that the van der Waals equation, okay, his full name is Johannes Diederik van der Waals. So van der Waals is essentially his last name. Okay, so van der Waals equation is just one improvement. Okay, that's why sometimes van der Waals equation is also known as van der Waals correction. Yeah, I'm pretty sure you've seen some videos online where the title of the video itself is van der Waals correction. Cool. So what we will do is we will take our very usual PV equal to nRT equation. This is exactly what we'll take, and we'll do slight amount of variation to this so that the equation now suits real gases a little better. Okay, there are some things that we will modify in this particular equation so that it suits the real gases better. Cool, awesome. Chalo ji, let's get into it. So before I get into it, as you saw in the beginning of the class itself, that we are running an amazing pro course at Vedantu. In case you want to enroll, the link is this one. It's in the description box down below. This is the coupon code. Very amazing course. Just look at it. I'll tell you the details of this course later in today's class. Okay? Chalo, ye link khol ke dekh lena. Main detail baad mein batata hu. So we know what the ideal gas equation is, but do you realize that whenever we talk about an ideal gas, we talk about a lot of assumptions? Yes, kafi sare assumptions karte hain apan. We assume that there are no forces of attraction between the gases. We assume that all the collisions are elastic. We assume that there is no loss in thermal energy. We assume that there is no potential energy. Only kinetic energy exists inside the gas. Yeah, remember kinetic theory of gases. We also assume that the volume of the ideal gas is negligible. So many assumptions. Yeah, it's like learning physics. My pulley has no mass in it. My string does not have, the string has uniform tension around it. There is no air drag. There is no friction. It doesn't make sense. Yeah. So right now, what we will do is we will take a few of these assumptions and tell those assumptions you are wrong. Okay. We will see the assumption and we'll say, foolish assumption, go away. I don't want assumption in life. I want reality. So what are those assumptions? First assumption that we think is wrong. Okay, the first assumption that we will say to modify the ideal gas equation, which is wrong, is there is no force of attraction between the molecules of a gas. Do you remember reading it from the NCERT? Do you remember reading it with me during kinetic theory of gases? In ideal gases, we assume that there is no force of attraction between the molecules of a gas, but we will say that this is wrong. Okay? We will now say that there is a force of attraction between different molecules of a gas. And in the previous few classes, I got a feedback from you that, sir, it is always better if you, you know, teach while writing on the board. So that is exactly what I'll do today for all of you. We will derive the equation step by step in our minds. Okay. So there is no force of attraction. So ye assumption ho gayi wrong. What is the correct thing? Attraction exists. Okay, great. So now let us think of a scenario. Let us imagine a box as usual. I'll just make a two-dimensional box. Okay, 3D box is too much artwork for me. So we'll just make a two-dimensional box so that it's easy for us to understand. And let's put a bunch of gaseous particles in it. Cool. These are particles of gas. Great. Now, my dear friends, How do these particles exert pressure on the container?
You all know that the outermost particles, yeah, the particles that are on the outer side, such as this particle, it will go and attack the wall of the container because it has some velocity. It hits the wall of the container. That force is what is translated as pressure because it is being put on an entire surface area. All the molecules are putting that force. Kinetic theory of gases once again. Think about the difference between pressure real versus pressure ideal. Ideal pressure is ideal pressure. Let us think how real pressure is different from ideal pressure. Ready? My dear friends, in the real scenario, what happens is that attraction exists. There are intermolecular forces of attraction. This molecule is attracting this molecule, this molecule is attracting this molecule is attracting this molecule. All the molecules are attracting each other. So what do you think will happen to the real pressure? Initially, there was no force of attraction, so I just go and bang into the wall. But now, inside the gas itself, there are some forces of attraction. They like to keep together with their own selves. वो खुद में बहुत खुश है रहना, है ना? तो what do you think? Will the collision with the wall be even more explosive? Explosive is not the good word. But will the collision be even more fast, even more energetic? Or will you be now slower with the collision? Think about it. Okay? Think about whether P real should be greater than P ideal. Now, thinking this might be a little too dry right now. हो सकता है मजा ना आए. Let me give you an analogy. Yeah, that's why we are here. So people imagine, okay? Imagine that there is some person, okay? There is a person and this guy is a sad person. Okay, sad person, he doesn't like to be around a lot of people, so he is alone. Okay, this sad person is alone and there is a wall. This is the example that I give to all my students. This is the wall. This sad person is very sad, so he just looks at the wall, and what he wants to do is, he is so frustrated, he wants to break that wall, he just wants to run into that wall. Okay, this sad person just wants to run into that wall. There is no one around him. He'll be able to run into the wall at a very high speed. इसको दीवार में घुसना, ये घुस जाएगा. Okay? बहुत तेज घुस जाएगा दीवार में. Right? But imagine the real scenario. Okay? What is the real scenario? For most humans, the real scenario is that there will be family around this guy. Yeah, there would be some friends. Maybe not exactly here, but maybe there are some friends and family. Yeah. So what these people will do is they will pull him. Yeah. They will not let him just run into the wall. They'll be like, "Arey, kya kar raha hai?" Yeah. We are here. So pakad lenge. They will hold this guy. Yeah. So forces of attraction towards all the friends, towards all the family members, etc., etc. Will this guy be able to run into the wall with full force now? क्या ये इंसान दीवार में एकदम जोर से घुस सकता है? नहीं. बिकॉज देर आर पीपल टू स्टॉप दैट पर्सन. देर आर पीपल टू स्टॉप दैट पर्सन. सो इन अ रियल सिनेरियो द फोर्स दैट दिस गाय कैन पुट ऑन द वॉल इज नॉट दैट मच. आई नो इट्स अ वेरी डिस्ट्रक्टिव एग्जाम्पल, काफी खतरनाक सा एग्जाम्पल ले लिया मैंने, बट अगेन इट्स ईजी टू इमेजिन, दैट्स वाई वी टुक दिस एग्जाम्पल. ओके, so in this scenario he won't be able to bang into the wall, he'll be stopped by the family members. Yes. Similarly over here, my dear friends, if this particle wants to bang onto the wall, if it is alone, it'll bang on with full force. Yes. But if there are other family members, if there are other molecules, of course there are. Yeah. These other molecules are now attracting this one inside. Yeah. So because of these inward forces of attraction, it won't be able to hit the wall with full force. It jayega. So do you understand that because the force being applied on the wall is lesser than the ideal scenario, P real will be less than P ideal. Do you get that? P real will be less than P ideal. Did you understand? P real is less than P ideal.
Because you just can't, yeah, put your head inside the wall. Cool. Adi, I've actually taken down the brightness today, bro. Just check karo apni taraf se thoda. I've actually reduced the brightness today of the class. Okay. So P real is less than P ideal. Now the next thing that we need to do is we need to quantify this. It's just a qualitative statement right now. We need to quantify this. So let's think about it. My dear friends, can I say, okay, I'm going to erase a lot of things over here. Ye sab main erase kar raha hun. Okay, because we need some space to write things down. What I will write is that P real, yeah, P real, thoda aur left pe likhta hun. Need space for calculation. This board just stopped working. Okay, chal pada. I hope so. Yeah, just a moment, people. This board sometimes is weird. So, P real is equal to P ideal minus something. Do you understand? P real will be P ideal minus something because P real is lesser than P ideal. Thoda sa kam rahega. Cool. Now, we need to quantify this something. Can I say, okay, can I say that if I have this box of particles, okay, so now my dear friends, this is a thought process that I'm trying to teach you. This is a very good thought process that Van der Waals himself had thought about. It might not be very obvious in the first go, but I'll try to explain the best as I can. ठीक है, ये thought process इतना obvious नहीं होगा, ये Van der Waals ने जो सोचा मैं आपको वो बता रहा हूँ. अब समझने की कोशिश करना, हो सकता है पहली बार में ना समझ आए, तो ध्यान से थोड़ा. ठीक है, at any given instant of time, okay, this reduction in pressure is because of what? Okay, at any given instant of time, how many molecules, okay, let's say the total number of molecules, okay, total number of molecules is equal to n. Inside this container, total number of gaseous particles is equal to capital N. At a specific time, how many particles can hit the wall? My question to you is, how many particles can hit the wall? Let's say this guy can hit the wall. This guy can hit the wall. This guy can hit the wall. Basically, the outer layer can hit the wall. Now, how do we decide how much is the outer layer? My dear friends, let me remind you, this is a gas. Okay. So, in a gas, do you realize that every particle will sometime go outside and hit the container? Since it's a gas, there is random motion. There is going to come a time where this guy also travels to the outside layer and hits the wall. It is possible that this guy also travels all over the place and hits the wall eventually. Overall, over a span of time, each and every particle can hit the wall. Yeah? Each and every particle hit the wall. Chalo, main brightness aur kam kar deta hun. If you guys think the brightness is high, look, reduced it one more notch. Okay? मैं काला दिखेगा एकदम. आई लुक वेरी वियर्ड राइट नाउ, बट एनीवे, इफ दिस इज बेटर, कूल. सो अंडरस्टूड? ठीक है, द टोटल नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल्स दैट कैन हिट द वॉल इज इक्वल टू एन. ओवर अ स्पैन ऑफ टाइम ईच एंड एवरी पार्टिकल विल बी एबल टू अप्रोच द वॉल. हर एक पार्टिकल जो यहां पे है कभी ना कभी तो दीवार पर टकरा ही जाएगा ना, है ना जी, कभी ना कभी तो दीवार पर टकरा ही जाएगा वो कंटेनर. सो हर पार्टिकल जो इस डब्बे में प्रेजेंट है वो प्रेशर एग्जर्ट कर सकता है. फाइन, हाउ मेनी पार्टिकल्स कैन हिट द वॉल? नाउ माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, माय क्वेश्चन टू यू इज, ओके, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, द रिडक्शन इन प्रेशर विल डिपेंड ऑन द रिड्यूस्ड प्रेशर. Reduction in pressure will depend on how much, you know, we are trying to reduce the pressure. How much are we trying to reduce the pressure? What does that depend on? It depends on the particles exerting the pressure. Kam pressure jo hum bata rahe ki itna pressure kam hoga, kis pe depend karta hai? जो लोग प्रेशर दे रहे हैं उन पे डिपेंड करता है. यस, इट डिपेंड्स ऑन द पीपल हु आर हिटिंग द वॉल हाउ मच प्रेशर यू हैव टू रिड्यूस. सो द नंबर ऑफ पीपल और नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल्स ओवर हियर हिटिंग द वॉल इज इक्वल टू एन. ओके, गॉट इट, फाइन. नाउ माय नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज अगेन द सेम सिस्टम, वी विल ड्रॉ इट अगेन इफ वी वॉन्ट. On an average, over a span of time, how many particles are causing the inward attraction? Can you tell me? How many particles over a span of time are causing inward attraction? ऐसे कितने particles हैं जो बाकी particles को अंदर attract कर रहे हैं over a span of time? Can you tell me? Rohit, yes, it's the non-ideal behavior of gases. Amit Kumar is asking, how can I be a master in chemistry? Amit, you can become a master in chemistry by stopping the spam in the chat box that you're creating and actually focusing on the class. भैया कॉपी पेस्ट करते रहोगे तो मास्टर कहां से बनोगे. हां जी बताओ दोस्तों, हाउ मेनी पार्टिकल्स आर कॉजिंग द इनवर्ड अट्रैक्शन? इफ ऑल द पार्टिकल्स कैन अटैक द वॉल वन डे, हाउ मेनी पार्टिकल्स कैन कॉज द इनवर्ड अट्रैक्शन वन डे? एन. यू माइट से सर ओके एन माइनस वन बिकॉज आई एम थिंकिंग अबाउट वन पार्टिकल, ऑल द अदर पार्टिकल्स. It's a very huge number, n minus 1, n, same thing. Yeah. So, all the particles are responsible for the pressure and all the particles are responsible for the reduction in pressure. Oye, oye. All right. So, my dear friends, these two statements were thought by van der Waals himself. And he said that this something is going to be proportional to n square. Okay. Johannes Diederik van der Waals said that this something is going to be proportional to n square. My dear friends, if this something is proportional to number of molecules square, can I say it is as good as, okay, can I say it is as good as, it is proportional to number of moles squared? Why square? Because particles causing the inward attraction, particles that are hitting the wall, these are what are causing the pressure, these are what are causing the reduction in pressure. ठीक है, सो द ओवरऑल रिडक्शन इन प्रेशर इज कॉज्ड बाय जो जो प्रेशर एक्सर्ट कर रहे हैं और कितना कम कर रहे हैं, एन. ओके, सो एन इनटू एन, एन स्क्वायर, एंड इंस्टेड ऑफ राइटिंग नंबर ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल स्क्वायर, इट्स बेटर दैट वी राइट नंबर ऑफ मोल स्क्वायर. सेम थिंग, राइट, प्रोपोर्शनैलिटी में इज द सेम थिंग. या सो अगेन दिस थॉट प्रोसेस माइट साउंड अ लिटिल डिफिकल्ट टू यू, बट थिंक अबाउट इट टू थ्री टाइम्स, आई एम प्रीटी श्योर यू विल बी एबल टू रैप योर हेड अराउंड इट. दिस इज द एग्जैक्ट थॉट प्रोसेस दैट वैन डर वॉल हैड टोल्ड, सो आई एम नॉट शुगर कोटिंग इट इन एनी मैनर. कूल. एंड आई हैव ऑल्सो सीन, जस्ट अ फेयर वार्निंग फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू, आई हैव ऑल्सो सीन दैट अ बंच ऑफ चैनल्स ऑनलाइन आर टीचिंग द incorrect way of thinking about the van der Waals equation. So let me tell you over here very clearly that this is exactly what was thought at the advent of this equation. Fine. So this something, this reduction is proportional to n square. Now my dear friends, do you realize that this n square, okay, that this n square, it's a very difficult thing to have in an equation. Okay, this is a very difficult thing to have in an equation. You'll be like, no, sir, why? I can measure the moles of the container. See, will I keep measuring the moles of the container? Will I keep measuring the molecules of the container for each and every different system? I want an equation that applies for every system. Do you realize if there is a system where are less number of moles, something else will happen? If there are more number of moles, something else will happen. Yeah. If there are lots of particles crowded with each other, maybe they attract each other very well and now they've become a liquid. Hai na? So, I need to turn this equation into something that is independent of the kind of system that I have. Okay? What I'm trying to say is, if you have 10 moles in a small system compared to 10 moles in a big system, do you realize the intermolecular forces will be different in both the cases? Agar main 10 mole itne se container mein lu versus 10 mole pure room mein le lu,
the intermolecular forces will be different. In one case, the molecules are very far from each other. In one case, the molecules are very slow from each other, very close to each other. Yeah. So my statement is that we have to normalize this particular. We have to normalize this particular equation. How do we normalize it? How do we make it standard for everything? Instead of taking number of moles. Now, number of moles is not a good measure because it could be in a small quantity, it could be in a big quantity. What is the specific measure that is independent of volume? What is the measure that is independent of volume? I'll tell you. Divide both of these by volume. How many particles are causing the inward attraction? Per unit volume. How many can hit the wall? Per unit volume. What I have done by dividing both of these things by V, I have taken the particle density inside that system. Maine particles ki seedha density le li yaar. ठीक है, तो इससे क्या हुआ, माय वॉल्यूम डिपेंडेंसी इज ओवर. इफ द वॉल्यूम ऑफ द सिस्टम इज बिग, इट विल कम हियर इन द इक्वेशन, कॉज नॉर्मलाइजेशन. इफ द वॉल्यूम ऑफ द सिस्टम इज स्मॉल, इट विल कम इन द इक्वेशन, नॉर्मलाइज द इक्वेशन. सो नाउ आई डू नॉट हैव टू वरी वेदर आई हैव 20 मोल्स इन दिस मच वॉल्यूम और 20 मोल्स इन द एंटायर रूम. ओके, ठीक है, मैं इतने से वॉल्यूम में 20 मोल लूं चाहे इतने वॉल्यूम में 20 मोल लूं, बात एक ही है क्योंकि मैंने वॉल्यूम से डिवाइड ही कर दिया. Density is what matters, yes. Two systems with same density but different sizes will have the same amount of intermolecular forces, yes. So that is why we will take density of particles over here, and this something will get proportional to n square by v square, or I can simply write small n square, that is number of moles square by v square. Okay? So with the entire analysis that we have done, एक बार फटाफट से रीकैप कर देता हूं. द वॉल्यूम एनालिसिस इज वेरी सिंपल, प्रेशर एनालिसिस इज अ लिटिल डिफिकल्ट. फर्स्ट थिंग वी अंडरस्टूड इज बिकॉज ऑफ इंटरमोलिकुलर फोर्सेस, पी रियल विल बी लेस देन पी आइडियल. सो वी रोट दैट पी रियल विल बी पी आइडियल माइनस सम क्वांटिटी. हाउ डू वी मेजर दिस क्वांटिटी? वी सेड दैट दिस क्वांटिटी वुड बी प्रोपोर्शनल टू द नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल्स एक्सर्टिंग प्रेशर एंड द नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल्स स्टॉपिंग दोज फ्रॉम एक्सर्टिंग प्रेशर, बिकॉज प्रेशर इज बीइंग एक्सर्टेड बाय द आउटर पार्टिकल्स एंड इनर पार्टिकल्स आर पुलिंग देम बैक. But over a span of time, because we are talking about macroscopic quantities, over a span of time, every particle can attack the wall and every particle has the opportunity to pull it back. N and N. Since I did not want volume to be, you know, some ambiguous factor, I wanted a small system and a big system to have the same equation, I just divided it by volume. So that now we are dealing with density. Yeah. When we are dealing with density, imagine that we are just taking out a unit volume from any system. Even if the system is the entire universe, density of the universe can be calculated from a very small part of the universe. Yeah, let's say you have this pen. Okay, let's say you have this pen. You know, I tell you to please calculate the density of the pen. Instead of trying to calculate the entire density, you can just cut the pen, take a small volume, which is easy to measure. The density of this part will be the density of the pen. Yeah. So that is why we are taking density over here, because whatever applies to a unit volume will apply to the entire system. And hence the something, the reduction in pressure turns into n square by v square. Cool. So ye hata raha hu main abhi. I will write. Try to clean the board to simplify things. P real is equal to P ideal. Minus something, okay, and this something depends on, okay, this something is proportional to n square by v square, number of moles squared by volume squared, because particle density into particle density. Now how do we remove the proportionality constant? How do we remove the proportionality? We put a constant over there. So my dear friends, this is what van der Waals said, that, okay, this is what van der Waals said. He said that this something, okay, this particular something is equal to a n square by v square. This constant a, okay, this constant a is known as the van der Waals constant. Okay. This is known as the van der Waals constant of pressure correction. I'll write over here of
pressure correction. All right. I hope you understand that. Van der Waals constant of pressure correction. Okay. This something is equal to An square by V square. This A is known as the Van der Waals constant of pressure correction. Got it? Mihir, no, it's not a premiere. It is live. If you have eyes, which I'm pretty sure you do because you're on YouTube, just open the, just click on the video. It says live at the bottom. If it is a premiered video, it says premiere at the bottom. So please, dhyan se dekho thoda, please. Okay. Adi is saying, if it is non-uniform density, what do we do? Very good question, bro. Non-uniform densities are actually our assumption that they don't exist in gases. We are assuming over here that gases are uniformly spread throughout the volume. If the density is non-uniform, then it is not an ideal gas anymore, yeah? Okay? So, good question, but again, that is not an ideal gas. And this particular correction is just one step further towards a real gas. Okay? ठीक है हजीरा कैन यू प्लीज टेल मी वेयर यू हैव अ डाउट सो दैट आई कैन रिपीट दैट स्पेसिफिक स्टेटमेंट बिकॉज आई हैव बीन सेइंग द सेम थिंग 3-4 टाइम्स ओके ऑलराइट अमूल्य रेडी इट डिपेंड्स ऑन द पार्टिकल्स दैट आर एक्सर्टिंग द प्रेशर एंड दैट प्रेशर इज इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय द इनवर्ड अट्रैक्शन ठीक है दैट्स वॉट द आइडिया इज रुद्रांश सिंह इट डज नॉट डिपेंड ऑन द मटेरियल ऑफ द कंटेनर नहीं 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 कंटेनर का तो कंटेनर इज जस्ट एन इमेजिनेशन फॉर अस राइट नाउ ओके कंटेनर कुड बी एनीथिंग फाइन वी आर अज्यूमिंग दैट द कोलिजन्स आर स्टिल इलास्टिक कोलिजन्स नो एनर्जी इज बीइंग लॉस्ट एनीवेयर वी आर जस्ट इंट्रोड्यूसिंग द आइडिया दैट देर आर अट्रैक्टिव फोर्सेस ओके तो यहां पर मैं बता रहा हूं वैन डर वाल्स कॉन्स्टेंट ऑफ प्रेशर करेक्शन नाउ समवन इज आस्किंग सर व्हाट डू दीज वैल्यूज सिग्निफाई आई विल टेल यू ओके तो यहां पे क्या आ जाएगा इसको कैसे लिखेंगे P real इज इक्वल टू P ideal माइनस ओके माइनस ए एन स्क्वायर बाय वी स्क्वायर लॉट ऑफ पीपल विल स्टार्ट शाउटिंग बट सर वैन डर वाल्स इक्वेशन इज P इक्वल टू P प्लस ए एन स्क्वायर बी स्क्वायर नो होल्ड ऑन ओके लॉट ऑफ यू विल से दैट सर वैन डर वाल्स इक्वेशन इज P plus An square by V square into V minus NB. We'll get there. Don't worry. This is correct. Okay. This is not wrong. Don't get confused. I'll tell you why there's a minus sign over here. So P real is equal to P ideal minus An square by V square. Okay. Fine. Ab, this A value, I'll tell you what is the significance of the A value. And you'll very easily understand the significance. Okay. Higher A value implies... Okay, please write this statement down. Higher A value implies more intermolecular forces. Higher A value implies more intermolecular forces. And you guys know that intermolecular forces are what? Intermolecular forces are attractive forces. Yes. Whenever I say intermolecular forces, it means forces of attraction between the molecules. Yes. So higher A value implies that the intermolecular forces are high. So if intermolecular forces are high, I'm holding the outward molecules even closer to myself. I'm not letting it hit the container. So the real pressure will be much less than the ideal pressure. क्योंकि मैं पार्टिकल्स को अच्छे से पकड़ के बैठा हूं मेरा ए वैल्यू बहुत ज्यादा है और पार्टिकल्स को अच्छे से पकड़ के बैठा हूं तो मेरा पार्टिकल दीवार पर टकरा ही नहीं पाएगा है ना तो क्योंकि वो दीवार पर टकरा ही नहीं पा रहा अच्छे से प्रेशर में बहुत ज्यादा रिडक्शन हो गया कैन यू सी इफ ए इज हाई प्रेशर रिडक्शन इज मोर इफ ए वैल्यू इज हाई ए वैल्यू इज ऑलवेज अ पॉजिटिव वैल्यू बाय द वे दिस विल ऑलवेज बी अ पॉजिटिव वैल्यू ए वैल्यू इफ इट इज हाई देन देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ रिडक्शन इन प्रेशर Yes. So higher A value signifies more intermolecular attractive forces. Fine. Got it. Chalo, to ye yaad rakhna. P real is equal to P ideal minus An square by V square. Okay, great. This is done. Right, this is the pressure correction. Let's get to the second assumption. It's much easier. Okay, pressure correction is done. Second assumption. we assume in the kinetic theory of gases, we assume for ideal gases that volume of the molecules of gas is negligible compared to the space occupied by the gas. Okay, we assume that volume of the molecules of gas is negligible compared to the space occupied by the gas. Okay, but that is again incorrect. The gaseous molecules have a finite volume. Okay, gas particles have a finite volume. ठीक है, दिस इज द आइडिया दैट गैस पार्टिकल्स हैव अ फाइनाइट वॉल्यूम. सो लेट अस मेक टू बॉक्सेस ओवर हियर. लेट्स मेक वन बॉक्स दैट इज आइडियल एंड लेट्स मेक अनदर बॉक्स, वेरी आइडेंटिकल बॉक्स, ओके, व्हिच इज रियल. नाउ माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, इन द आइडियल केस द गैशियस मॉलिक्यूल्स आर ऑफ नेग्लिजिबल वॉल्यूम. ये वॉल्यूम ही नहीं है, कूल. बट इन द रियल केस दीज पार्टिकल्स एक्चुअली हैव सम वॉल्यूम. या थोड़ा थोड़ा वॉल्यूम तो रहेगा ना इनका, देयर विल बी सम वॉल्यूम. सो दे आर नॉट डॉट्स एनी मोर, दे आर दीज टाइनी टाइनी स्फीयर्स. ये दे आर दीज टाइनी टाइनी स्फीयर्स, दे आर नॉट जस्ट पार्टिकल्स एनी मोर, दे आर स्फीयर्स. सो माई डियर फ्रेंड्स, डू यू रियलाइज, ओके, बिकॉज दीज आर फाइनाइट साइज्ड पार्टिकल्स, कैन आई से दैट ओवर हेयर more collisions will happen? If this volume and this volume, the volume of the container, if both the volumes of the containers are the same, can I say that over here more collisions will happen? Isn't that obvious? Why will more collisions happen? Because there is less space. Yeah? Imagine two very thin people inside a small room. Aram se padhe. Imagine two very huge people inside the same room. Imagine Great Khali and Big Show sitting inside the IIT Bombay hostel. Some of you must have seen the movie Chichore. IIT Bombay hostels are very small, very tiny places, okay? You can hardly fit two full single beds over there. If you put a double bed in one IIT Bombay room, there is no more space. It's that smaller room, okay? So imagine a room that is just the size of a double bed, okay? And you put the Great Khali and the Big Show, you know those two guys, wrestlers, okay, huge people, in that room. Do you realize they will just keep colliding with each other all the time? So bigger particles in the same volume will collide more often. And since they will collide more often, do you realize they will collide with the walls of the container more often? More collisions will happen. This implies more collisions with the wall. If Great Khali and Big Show are inside a room, they will definitely just break the door and come out. Yeah, because the room is so small, they can't just stay there. So they will put a lot of pressure on the room, they will break the door and they will come out. So if there are more collisions, there will be more collisions with the wall. My handwriting is very beautiful, as you can see. I have written more collisions with the wall. If you're listening, you know. ठीक है, ये आ बात हो गई. Now, how do we decide difference between V real and V ideal? I am just saying कि more collisions will happen. अच्छा ठीक है. Now, my question to you is, I'll write the question over here. You have to tell me the answer. Okay? Very, very, very important question. मैं लिखता हूं, आई विल ट्राई टू फ्रेम इट इन द बेस्ट पॉसिबल मैनर. ओके, इफ आई वॉन्ट टू कीप द सेम प्रेशर, ओके, इफ आई वॉन्ट टू कीप द सेम प्रेशर इन बोथ कंटेनर्स, आई शुड डैश. डैश में क्या भरना है? यू हैव टू राइट इंक्रीज और डिक्रीज. दिस फिल इन द ब्लैंक कैन बी फिल्ड बाय द वर्ड इंक्रीज और डिक्रीज. सो इफ आई वॉन्ट टू कीप द सेम प्रेशर इन बोथ द कंटेनर्स, आई शुड डैश, ओके, आई शुड डैश द रियल वॉल्यूम. क्या करना चाहिए? if I have to keep both the pressures the same, okay, if I want to keep pressures the same in both the cases, should I give them a little more space or should I compress them even more? Nofis is saying, sir, your rank was approximately 33,000. How did you get into IIT Bombay? I opened the door and went in, bro. So everyone who's skeptical about me being from IIT Bombay, I'll show you my degree someday. People, in IIT Bombay, you can get an admission till the rank of All India General Category 4,000. Okay? Please do your research before pointing fingers at people who are actually doing some efforts for you. Okay? Please, yaar, thoda class pe dhyan de diya karo. कुछ चीजें गूगल की जा सकती है, कर लिया करो. सो एज आई कैन सी फ्रॉम अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल इन द चैट बॉक्स, सम पीपल आर गिविंग मी द इनकरेक्ट आंसर, बट ठीक है. The idea is, if I want to keep both the pressures the same, let this be the ideal case. Real case mein, if I give Big Show and Khali a little more space, they will be able to exist very happily. Yeah, they will be able to exist very happily. So, my dear friends, all I need to do is just increase the virial slightly. If I want to keep the pressure the same, I should increase the real volume. Fine. So overall, what are we getting from this idea? We are getting V real for the same pressure conditions has to be greater than V ideal. Yes. So similarly, like the pressure case, I can write over here that V real is equal to V ideal plus something. And to take this something is very easy, okay? To decipher this something is very easy. ठीक है? ये something क्या होगा? How much relaxation do I have to give to the real case? How much relaxation do I have to give to the real case? Let's give it relaxation equal to the volume of the particles themselves. All right? All of you who are here to learn in Hindi, I do not teach in Hindi, I teach only in English because our very own Arvind Arora sir is teaching in Hindi on Vedantu's NEET channel. You can go and watch his classes for Hindi. Agar aap Hindi mein padhna chahte hain, to hamare priya adhyapak Arvind Arora ji, hamare NEET channel pe pehle hi kaksha Hindi ki bhasha mein le rahe hain, to aap us jagah jaakar apni adhyayan ki pratikriya ko aage badha sakte hain. Ji? अगर आप पढ़ना नहीं चाहते तो आप कहीं भी जा सकते हैं. वो तो आपकी मर्जी है. कूल. सो वी रियल इज इक्वल टू वी आइडियल प्लस समथिंग. या नाउ ऑफ कोर्स दिस समथिंग, ओके, दिस रिलैक्सेशन, दिस इंक्रीज इन वॉल्यूम दैट वी आर प्रोवाइडिंग हैज टू बी प्रोपोर्शनल टू द वॉल्यूम ऑफ द पार्टिकल्स देमसेल्व्स. या इनिशियली देयर वाज नो वॉल्यूम फॉर द पार्टिकल्स, नाउ वी हैव टू प्रोवाइड एक्स्ट्रा स्पेस फॉर दोज स्पेसिफिक पार्टिकल्स. सो दिस समथिंग विल, माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, बी प्रोपोर्शनल टू व्हाट? दिस समथिंग विल बी प्रोपोर्शनल टू द वॉल्यूम ऑफ द गैसियस पार्टिकल्स. सो यू विल से दैट, ओके सर, दिस इज वेरी सिंपल, आई कैन राइट दैट दिस विल बी इक्वल टू एन, दिस इज द नंबर ऑफ मोल्स इन टू volume per mole. Volume per mole can be written as, okay, 4 upon 3 pi r cube. This is the volume for one molecule. Volume for one molecule into the Avogadro's number. Na is what? The Avogadro's number. Okay? So volume for one particle into one mole. This is the molar volume. So volume of one mole of particles into the total number of moles. This is the volume of the particles themselves. This is the relaxation that I have to provide them. So, total number of moles, volume for one particle, Avogadro's number. Volume for one particle into Avogadro's number, this entire thing becomes molar volume of particles. Yeah. volume occupied by just the particles, okay, not the volume of the container. I am talking about just the particle volume. So this particle plus this particle, this particle, this particle. So this volume occupied, that is what I am talking about. Okay. So you will say, sir, it is very simple. It should be n into 4 by 3 pi r cube into na. Okay, fine, fine, fine.
But my dear friends, think,
is that relaxation enough? Not really.
Think about a container where you have put all the gaseous particles in one corner. How? Something like this. You have kept them right next to each other, okay? All the gaseous particles, which I have exaggerated in size over here, I have kept all of them at one corner of this container, right? This is where all of them are.
My dear friends, I will shade a specific area and you will realize that that volume is also occupied by these molecules. That volume also has to be compensated for. Us volume ko bhi thoda increase dena padega apne ko.
Look at this volume. Do you realize that these particles are not only occupying their own volume, but they are blocking some side volume as well?
Yeah, they are blocking some side volume as well. Imagine Great Khali and Big Show in a room together, but now you add up their volumes and give them a room which is exactly equal to volume Khali plus volume Big Show. They still can't fit in that room, isn't it? You will have to provide a room that is a little bigger than volume Khali plus volume Big Show, because they need some place to stand, right? They can't just merge into each other and stand, right? So because this particular volume that I've shaded in red is your incompressible volume, we have to account for this volume as well in the volume correction. Is volume ko bhi hame thoda sa volume correction mein dalna padega. Fine. So my dear friends, now the thing over here is, if this is the incompressible volume, this something is equal to total incompressible volume. Okay, this is equal to total incompressible volume. Okay, now imagine there are spheres right next to each other. So inside those spheres, there will be some gaps, etc. So we have to account for the volume of the gaps according to some mathematical approximation. Now, what is the approximation? It will be too much to talk about right now. Agar main mathematics approximation mein chala gaya, toh bahut zyada time lag jayega. Let me tell you straight away that the total incompressible volume, okay, total incompressible volume is equal to 4 into 4 by 3 pi r cube. This is the total incompressible volume occupied by one particle. And this, when multiplied by the total number of particles, this particular thing is your something. Incompressible volume occupied by all the particles. We have to compensate for this volume. Okay, we have to compensate for this volume. If I have to put these two guys together, yeah, I have to account for their personal space as well. So I should give them a container which has this much volume plus this much volume. You understand? I can't just take the volumes of their heads and give them a container to sit in, which is just equal to the volumes of their heads. No, I have to account for their personal space as well. And that is the room that I will provide them. So over here, once again, after accounting for all the personal space, this something is equal to 4 into the volume of every particle into the total number of particles. This total number of particles obviously can be written as the Avogadro's number into the number of moles. Small n is number of moles, capital Na is Avogadro's number. If you don't understand mole concept, then please revise that chapter. Cool. So total incompressible volume is this much. I will erase everything and write down the final formula that we have. And the final formula should be, the final formula will be V real is equal to V ideal minus, okay, वी आइडियल माइनस, सॉरी माइनस लिख रहा हूं यहां पे, वी आइडियल प्लस बिकॉज वी बिकॉज आर रियल वॉल्यूम इज अ लिटिल ग्रेटर देन आइडियल वॉल्यूम, वी अंडरस्टूड दैट. सो वी रियल इज वी आइडियल प्लस, क्या था वो समथिंग, 4 इंटू 4 अपॉन 3 पाई आर क्यूब इंटू एवोगैड्रोस नंबर इंटू नंबर ऑफ मोल्स, है ना. This is the incompressible volume occupied by the gaseous particles themselves. This is their own volume plus their personal space that they want to sit. ठीक है, got it? Now, my dear friends, this entire thing can't be written like this all over the place. This particular box is simply written as B. What is this B? This B is also known as the van der Waals constant of volume correction. Bigger molecule implies bigger volume of the molecule, implies higher value of B. So, bigger gases, heavier gases, gases that have more volume of their individual molecules will have a higher volume of, will have a higher value of B. ठीक है, cool, got it. चलो जी, तो ये हो गया, बहुत बढ़िया, fine. Van der Waals constant of volume correction, B. So now, let us try to figure out the final Van der Waals equation. Our analysis is finally coming to a good end. ठीक है, तो यहां क्या आएगा दोस्तों, P real is equal to P ideal minus n square by v square. This is the first equation. I hope you've written it down. What's the second equation? V real is equal to V ideal plus B into n. B is the incompressible volume occupied by all the particles. N is the number of, I mean, N is the number of moles. So, B is incompressible volume per mole. ठीक है? Rohit, I had explained why I multiplied it with 4. I had multiplied it with 4 because I had to account for their personal space as well. You can't just compress all the spheres together. There are some gaps left between the spheres and we have to account for that volume as well. That mathematical approximation comes to 4 times the volume of one sphere itself. ठीक है, that is the idea. So my department in IIT was 5-year integrated MSc chemistry का course था दोस्त, आप देख सकते हैं उस चीज को ऑनलाइन, यू कैन फिगर दैट आउट. चलो, कूल. तो ये हो गया अपने पास, P real is equal to P ideal minus AN square by V square and V real is equal to V ideal minus V real is equal to V ideal plus N times B. So finally, my dear friends, what can we do with these two? Do you remember this very famous equation PV equal to NRT? ये तो याद ही होगा. Let me remind you, this pressure that is over here, this pressure is P ideal, isn't it? This is the ideal gas equation. So you put ideal pressure over here. The volume that you put over here, what is that volume? You put the ideal volume. You put ideal pressure over here. You put ideal volume over here. My dear friends, all you need to do is substitute the values. Put the value of V ideal over here. Put the value of P ideal over here. Once you put those values, I can write this equation as, yeah, I can write this equation as P real plus N square by V square into V real. Okay, this volume is also V real, by the way. Okay, so P real plus N square by V square into V real minus NB is equal to NRT, and this is your recognized form of the van der Waals equation. Got it?
This is the van der Waals equation.
Sometimes I've seen online that they end up substituting P real and V real over here. Please don't do that. We have to substitute the values of P ideal and V ideal into the ideal gas equation. These are the corrections which we have completely figured out in the entire class today. And finally, this is the form of the van der Waals equation, Johannes Diederik van der Waals equation. Let me write it in a much more beautiful fashion over here. P plus AN square by V square into V minus NB is equal to NRT. Real pressure, van der Waals constant that relates to intermolecular forces, also known as van der Waals constant of pressure correction. Number of moles, real volume. Real volume, yet again, number of moles. Incompressible volume occupied per mole. Number of moles, universal gas constant, temperature. This is your van der Waals equation. Okay. So what you need to remember is that higher A value is higher intermolecular forces and higher B value is higher size of individual particles. That's all. Cool. So now let us try to do some questions. We have another 5 minutes. Let's do this question. Simple question. It came in JEE Main 2004. In van der Waals equation of state of the gas law, the constant B is a measure of intermolecular repulsion, intermolecular attraction, volume occupied by the molecules, intermolecular collisions per unit volume. This used to be a JEE Main question. Now the JEE Main's level has obviously increased a little. Just included this question over here so that we can warm ourselves up. ठीक है चलो ये क्वेश्चन हो गया अच्छा क्वेश्चन था नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन दिस क्वेश्चन इज अ होमवर्क क्वेश्चन आई विल कम बैक टू दिस लेट्स डू दिस क्वेश्चन फर्स्ट ओके अरे यार लेट्स डू दिस क्वेश्चन सो दिस इज अ वेरी ओल्ड जे एडवांस्ड क्वेश्चन सच क्वेश्चंस नाउ डू कम इन जे मेंस सो लेट्स रीड इट आउट इन द वैन डर वाल्स इक्वेशन ऑफ स्टेट फॉर अ नॉन आइडियल गैस द टर्म दैट अकाउंट्स फॉर इंटरमोलिकुलर फोर्सेस इज P plus AN square by V square or V minus NB? Kaun si? V minus B was volume correction. This was because of volume. RT is always RT. Isko kya karenge? RT inverse. What? Where did this come from? P plus A by V square. They are assuming that it's just one mole of gas. So, my dear friends, the pressure correction includes intermolecular forces in it. Because of high intermolecular forces, your pressure cannot be exerted on the walls of the container. Okay, so this is a simple question. Sometimes this question, I've seen it getting repeated in JEE mains as well, especially in NEET. NEET mein, sometimes a lot of easy questions come from chemistry because you have to solve like 50 questions. 50 होता है ना काफी सारे क्वेश्चन करने पड़ते हैं 45 क्वेश्चंस 50 क्वेश्चंस इन जस्ट वन आवर या नीट स्टूडेंट्स हैव दिस 45 क्वेश्चंस इन वन आवर सो दैट्स व्हाई नीट क्वेश्चंस ऑफ केमिस्ट्री आर जनरली इजी सच क्वेश्चंस कैन इजीली कम फॉर नीट एस्पिरेंट्स एंड यू मस्ट बी थिंकिंग सर दिस इज अ वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन व्हाई यू टीचिंग दिस यू नो दैट इट्स एन इजी क्वेश्चन बिकॉज यू हैव अंडरस्टूड द एंटायर एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ द वैन डर वाल्स इक्वेशन विद मी If you hadn't done that, if you didn't know the entire explanation, if you didn't know the derivation, then this is a very difficult question. If you have just read the equation, okay, let's say you are someone who is preparing for JEE 10 days before JEE, and you're like, okay, P plus N square by V square, V minus NB, P plus N square by V square. You have no idea what is P plus N square by V square, what is V minus NB. So right now you know that the pressure reduction happens because of the intermolecular forces, hence you know that the pressure correction term accounts for the intermolecular forces. Good. Next question. The value of van der Waals constant A for the gases, this are given. So values for A are given. Which gas can most easily be liquefied? It's a very good question. These questions are now standard in JEE mains. These questions are standard in NEET. A values are given. Okay, so what did I tell you? I told you that if A value is high, this implies that intermolecular forces are high. More A value, more intermolecular forces. So what does this imply? My dear friends, if there are higher intermolecular forces, I can keep those molecules together. If you like your surroundings, if you like the people that are around you, if you like your neighbors, let's say, I can put all of you in one house and you will be happy. Yeah. So what is a liquid? Liquid is something that is compressed compared to a gas. Liquid is something where the molecules exist closer to each other than a gas. The molecules will be happy to exist closer to each other if the intermolecular forces are higher. So higher A value implicitly tells you that it is easily liquefiable. All right? Because you have more forces of attraction, you can keep them together. It implies that it's easier to liquefy that gas. So highest A value is there for NH3. Answer becomes option number C. Yeah, cool. So now, this is your homework question, by the way. And I'm pretty sure you can solve this question. It's a JEE Advanced previous year question. It's a very good question. So take this as a homework. This is your Hall of Fame question. Answer in the comment section down below. Just note down this question. And for all of you who are asking about previous classes Hall of Fame question, I'll do it after this one. Okay, just note it down. I'll show you the previous classes Hall of Fame question as well very soon. Okay, so I hope you've noted it down. अब मैं पिछले वाले का आपको बताता हूं क्या सीन चल रहा है. This was the homework from the previous class. Okay, so all of you who are attending my classes regularly, you would be enjoying this concept of Hall of Fame. देखते हैं. The kinetic energy of one mole of gas is given by the expression K equals to 3 PV by 2 and K is equal to 3 by 2 RT. KE means kinetic energy. Cool. Hence, it can be said that kinetic energy is proportional to P at constant temperature. My dear friends, this first statement is incorrect.
Hey, how, sir?
I'll tell you how. Kinetic energy is equal to 3 by 2 PV. But the condition is delta T is equal to 0. My dear friends, if temperature is not changing, do you realize that pressure into volume is also not changing? If temperature is not changing, you know PV is equal to nRT, and we are assuming that the number of moles of the gas is constant. If temperature increases, this entire side will increase. If temperature decreases, this entire side will decrease. Yes, isn't it? So the thing is that if your temperature is constant, if you increase the pressure, the volume will automatically decrease. There will be no change in internal energy. Internal energy of an ideal gas depends only on the temperature of the gas. If you fix the temperature, if the change in temperature is zero, if you increase the pressure, volume will automatically decrease to keep the temperature constant. So change in internal energy, change in kinetic energy will also be zero. Internal energy will not be changed. So kinetic energy is proportional to P at constant temperature. No, kinetic energy is not going to change at constant temperature. Same thing over here. Okay, kinetic energy is proportional to temperature at constant pressure. Absolutely. This is the formula. Kinetic energy is directly proportional to temperature. You keep varying the pressure, volume will vary, but if you vary the temperature, direct relation with kinetic energy. Always remember that the energy of a gas, ideal gas, depends only and only on its temperature. Fine. And the third statement is kinetic energy is not directly proportional to the volume at constant temperature. Absolutely correct. Change in kinetic energy is zero at constant temperature. So the answer to this question becomes option number B and C. And now's the time when I take the names of a few people who've given me the correct answer in the previous class. So this is what I've opened for you. This was the lecture number 5 in which I had asked this question. Let me sort the comments by newest first. And let's go to the bottom of the question to see. Let's go to the bottom of the chat box to see किसने क्या आंसर दिया. अच्छा ये मैं कॉमेंट पिन कर देता हूँ. ओके, सो दे वर सेइंग आंसर वुड बी सी. सी इज करेक्ट बट आंसर शुड बी बी एंड सी. ओके, बालाजी इज सेइंग आंसर फॉर द हॉल ऑफ फेम क्वेश्चन इज बी एंड सी. एब्सोल्युटली गुड जॉब. Srikakulam, incorrect. Ajita, you missed one answer. Bro, you also missed one answer. I can't read your name, sorry. Aditya, very good job. Suhani, thank you so much. Suhani, option C is correct, but option B is also correct. Yeah. And Dinesh. Dinesh, I do teach on YouTube. I will give you the details of my paid courses sometime. I take only specific sessions in the paid courses. Okay? So when that happens, I will let you guys know. Fine. So great. Ye bhi ho gaya. Deepak is saying C. B is also a correct answer. I hope you understand. Okay? Chalo, Lavanya. Again, B is also a correct answer. Kosta, very good job. Nice. Saurav, yeah, you are correct, but C is also a correct statement technically in this question. Bhavna, you missed one option. Adi, good job. Dinesh, you missed a specific option. Chalo, aur kisi ne diya hai kya? B and C. Vishnu, very good job. And Dhruv, very nice. Santosh, you accidentally added another option. Amulya Reddy, very good job. Aur kisi ne diya hai kya sahi answer? Piyush, very nice. Chalo, badhiya. So, all of these people who were able to get the correct answer. Good job. Very nice. High five. Proud of you guys. Chalo ji. So my dear friends, this is your homework question. Please make sure you do it before the next class. So next class of this chapter is going to happen on Thursday at 7 p.m. That will also be a live class. And the good news for all of you is that we are running a pro course at Vedanta. Now, what is this pro course? Kya hota hai pro course? Let me just simply show you a video and you'll understand that better. यार ये साउंड कहाँ चली जाती है मुझे पता नहीं लगता सॉरी साउंड मिस हो गया सो व्हाट आई वाज सेइंग इज दैट फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू हु आर ट्राइंग टू प्रिपेयर फॉर जेई 2020 द जेई 2020 क्लासेस हैपन एट 8:30 ऑन दिस चैनल ओके सो टुडे आल्सो एट 8:30 देयर इज अ स्ट्रेटजी सेशन दैट वी विल डू एंड इन दैट स्ट्रेटजी सेशन आई विल टेल यू एग्जैक्टली व्हाट यू नीड टू डू फॉर द नेक्स्ट 15 टू 20 डेज राइट बिफोर योर एग्जामिनेशन सो एनीवन एंड एवरीवन हु हैज अ डाउट रिगार्डिंग दैट प्लीज जॉइन मी एट 8:30 नाउ अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट दीज क्लासेस आर the class that I did today, it's for regular 11th class students who wanted to learn the chapter of gaseous state for the very first time. So 2020 students, these regular classes are not the best for you. You should spend your time doing more question solving and revision. I'll tell you exactly what you need to do in the last 15 to 20 days at 8:30 p.m. Fine. Okay. Chalo, badhiya hai. Cool. Anyway, people, we will see each other in the next 20 minutes if you are here to prepare for 2020 examination. And yeah, that's it from my side for today. Thank you so much for watching. It was a difficult equation to understand for the very first time. In case you didn't understand, you can try and watch it again. There is a very beautiful video on Van der Waals equation by Khan Academy. Okay, so KHAN Academy, that's a very beautiful website and a very beautiful YouTube channel that you can refer to if you want to, you know, just supplement your information of the videos. Those videos are a little high level, so if you're going to those videos for the very first understanding, it might not be possible. But if you watch this video and then see Khan Academy's video for reference, it might be of help.
That's it from my side. Hit that like button, stay subscribed. I will see you guys very soon. Bye bye.